Hi everyone, our subject today is anemia in pediatrics. Basics. Anemia is defined as a decrease in hemoglobin concentration of more than 2 standard deviations below the mean. Normal value of hemoglobin and hematocrit vary with the age and gender, so it is important to use age and sex adjusted norms. Race may also influence norm. African American children have a normal hemoglobin that may be 0.5 gram per deciliter, less than white or Asian children. Adolescent females often have lower hemoglobin than males of the same age range. A term infant has a normal hemoglobin level of 15 to 21 gram per deciliter, followed by a physiological nadir of 9.5 to 10 gram per deciliter around 2 months of age. This is exaggerated in premature infant. Risk factor for anemia. Age 6 to 9 week, physiologic anemia of infancy. Approximate hemoglobin nadir is 11 gram. Not physiologic if accompanied by abnormal sign on physical examination. 9-month-old toddler. Higher risk for iron deficiency in setting of a diet consisting almost exclusive of iron poor whole milk. Also lead poisoning. Race and ethnicity. G6PD in the Sephardic Jew, Filipinos, Greece, Sardinians, Kurd, and African American population. Thalassemia syndrome in children of Southeast Asia and Mediterranean descent. Hemoglobinopathy, hemoglobin S, hemoglobin C in African American and Hispanic population. Gender, male more likely to have G6PD deficiency, X-linked sideroblastic anemia. Postmenarchal female, consider excessive menstrual or dysfunctional uterine bleeding. Other risk factor to consider, comorbidities, anemia of chronic disease, impaired absorption of GIT disorder, acute blood loss in setting of hemophilia, underlying renal disease, malignancy, diet, excessive milk intake, may cause iron deficiency, exclusive breastfeed by vegetarian mother, vitamin B12 deficiency. History. History should include iron source in the diet. Infant with excessive intake, 24 hours per day of cow milk or low iron formula at a risk. Allergy to cow milk may also cause occult gastrointestinal blood losses. Goat milk is associated with the folate deficiency and vitamin B12 deficiency occur in those with on macrobiotic diet. Increased iron requirement occur as a result of increased menstrual blood loss, pregnancy, and prematurity. Impaired absorption of iron may be associated with the malabsorption syndrome such as inflammatory bowel disease or celiac disease. Pike may suggest lead poisoning. A neonatal history of hyperbilirubinemia may indicate a congenital hemolytic anemia, especially if there is a family history of anemia, splenectomy, or cholecystectomy. Sickle cell anemia is more common in those of African descent. Medication may lead to hemolysis as in G6PD deficiency. Infection and chronic disease are also associated with anemia. Travel history may reveal infectious such as malaria. Medication, current and past medication, can precipitate immune-mediated hemolysis. Penicillin, quinidine, methildopa, or aplastic crisis like chemotherapeutic agent, chloramphenicol, sulfonamide, anticonvulsant, cimetidine, toxin like benzene, glazed ceramic, home renovation, insecticide, paint. Symptoms. Common symptoms of anemia, fatigue, exercise intolerance, syncope. Infant may present with the irritability, poor oral intake. Children with the chronic anemia may be asymptomatic due to physiologic compensation. Symptoms indicate blood loss, epistaxis, excessive menstrual bleeding, hematochezia, melena, diet history, milk intake, pica and iron deficiency anemia or lead poisoning, fava bean in G6PD. Physical examination. In general, anemia, unless acute, may be asymptomatic until the hemoglobin level is less than 7 to 8 grams per deciliter. Clinical feature can include pallor, fatigue, irritability, and decreased exercise tolerance. A flow murmur may be present. Severe anemia may cause tachypnea, tachycardia, and ultimate heart failure. Chronic anemia may affect growth. Chronic hemolytic anemia may cause expansion of the bone marrow with the prominent cheekbones, frontal bossing, and dental malocclusion. Splenomegaly may be present. Lymphadenopathy and hepatosplenomegaly occur with the infiltrative disease of the bone marrow. Examination may also reveal sign of systemic disease. A careful skin examination may reveal bruising or purpura. Common finding in anemia, vital sign, tachycardia, hypotension, including orthostatic, especially in setting of acute, severe blood loss, tachypnea, heart murmur, hepatomegaly, pallor, sign of hemolysis, dark urine, jaundice, scleral icterus, splenomegaly. Specific finding associated with certain condition, ductalitis, sickle cell anemia, glossitis, B12 deficiency, lymphadenopathy, neoplastic process, petechia purpura, DIC, hemolytic uremic syndrome, infection, pancytopenia, syndromic features, limb anomaly in Fanconi, diamond black fan anemia. How to approach to child with the anemia after performing history and physical examination? Hemoglobin, PCV, correlate with the gender and age, as we mentioned previously. If it is decreased, look for white BC and platelet or platelet. If it is decreased, one of them, white BC or platelet, besides the hemoglobin, this is pancytopenia or dicytopenia. Patient need history and clinical examination, peripheral smear, bone marrow examination to rule out other disorder associated with anemia, like myelodysplastic syndrome, aplastic anemia. If the white BC and or platelet normal, RBC indices to categorized anemia morphologically, either according to the MCV, low microcytic, normal normocytic, elevated macrocytic. Now we start with the microcytic anemia. Patient need iron study. If it is decreased serum ferritin, decreased iron level, elevated total iron binding capacity, this is iron deficiency anemia. If it is normal or elevated serum ferritin, normal or decreased total iron binding capacity, patient need LDH, unconjugated serum bilirubin, reticulocyte count. If it is normal, patient need peripheral smear. If there is coarse basophilic stippling from the history, you can diagnose lead poisoning. If there is in the peripheral smear, dual population, patient need bone marrow aspiration. If there is ring sideroblast, this is sideroblastic anemia. If the peripheral smear show no abnormality, this is anemia of chronic disease. If the retic count or bilirubin or LDH increased, patient need hemoglobin electrophoresis for hemoglobin F, hemoglobin A2. If it is abnormal, this is beta thalassemia, alpha thalassemia trait, hemoglobinopathy, hemoglobin C, hemoglobin E, H disease. If it is normal electrophoresis, patient need peripheral smear. If it is abnormality like elliptocytosis or pyroperkylocytosis, or if the peripheral smear show no abnormality, investigation for erythropoietic porphyria. If it is macrocytic anemia, increased MCV, is there oval macrocyte and hypersegmented neutrophil on the peripheral smear? If it is present, this is a macrocytic megaloblastic anemia. This is B12 or folic acid level patient need. If it is decreased, this is B12 or folic acid deficiency. Investigation for cause including dietary increase requirement or decrease absorption. If it is normal B12 or folic acid level, normal or increased, investigate for homocysteinuria, inherited disorder, a drug that interfere with the DNA synthesis, or HIV infection on Zidovudine therapy. If there is no hypersegmented neutrophil, this is macrocytic non-megaloblastic anemia. Patient need retic count. If it is increased, this is reticulocytosis due to blood loss or hemolysis. If the retic count normal or decreased, patient need clinical and lab investigation correlation for Down syndrome, Fanconi anemia, liver disease, or hypothyroidism. If there is no contributory history or lab finding, bone marrow examination for myelodysplastic syndrome, a pure RPC, aplasia, diamond black fan anemia. If it is normocytic anemia, patient need retic count. If it is decreased or normal retic count, history and investigation for chronic illness, liver disease, renal disease, endocrine disease, early iron deficiency, if it is positive according to the history and examination. If it is negative, bone marrow, patient need bone marrow aspiration to rule out myelodysplastic syndrome, a pure RPC aplasia, and metastatic deposit. If the retic count elevated in normocytic anemia, patient need serum bilirubin, LDH. If it is normal, this is acute blood loss. If it is increased bilirubin, patient need peripheral smear. Look for a spherocyte. If it is positive, patient need direct Coombe test. If it is positive Coombe test, this is autoimmune hemolytic anemia, hemorrhagic disease of a newborn, hemolytic transfusion reaction. If it is negative Coombe test, this is hereditary spherocytosis. If there is no spherocyte, look for fragmented RBC on peripheral smear. If it is positive, this is hemolytic uremic syndrome, DIC, vasculitis, SLE, malignant hypertension, or secondary to acute infection. Confirmation according to the clinical data of each specific disease. If it is negative, there is no fragmented RBC. Investigation for specific feature of different hemolytic anemia, G6PD, infection, paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria. This is another approach to the anemia according to the retic count. After performing history and physical examination, peripheral smear, retic count. If it is anemia of underproduction, which means retic count less than 2-3%, as we mentioned, either low MCV, microcytic anemia, consider iron study, HB electrophoresis, bone marrow aspiration if needed. Differential diagnosis, iron deficiency anemia, thalassemia trait, lead poisoning, anemia of chronic disease, sideroblastic anemia, and copper deficiency. If it is normocytic anemia, normal MCV, consider iron study, serum creatinine, thyroid and liver function test, bone marrow aspiration. If it is pancytopenia, this is leukemia, malignancy, acquired aplastic anemia. If it is isolated normocytic anemia, could be iron deficiency anemia, acquired red cell aplasia, acute infection, a transient erythroblastopenia, medication, anemia of chronic disease, renal disease, hypothyroidism. If it is elevated MCV, macrocytic anemia, as we mentioned, patient need B12 and folate level, thyroid and liver function test, consider referral for bone marrow aspiration. Differential diagnosis, megaloblastic anemia, diamond black fan anemia, Fanconi anemia, liver disease, and hypothyroidism. If it is anemia of underproduction, overproduction, retic count more than 2 to 3%, look for urine color. If it is yellow, clear, concentrated, with or without a decreased amount, if there is evidence of a blood loss, this is anemia due to hemorrhage. If the urine color, tea color, coffee ground, cola-like, or with or without jaundice, splenomegaly, with the evidence of hemolysis, this is hemolytic anemia. Patient need Coombs test. Either Coombs positive test in immune-mediated anemia, ABO incompatibility, Rh incompatibility, autoimmune hemolytic anemia, and systemic lupus erythematosus. If it is Coombs negative, consider electrophoresis, G6PD deficiency, and osmotic fragility test. Differential diagnosis, sickle cell disease, thalassemia, G6PD deficiency, microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, membrane defect, spherocyte, and elliptocytosis. This is a simple differentiation between different type of anemia. In iron deficiency anemia, there is possible splenomegaly, with low ferritin, decreased MCV, and there is no jaundice. In thalassemia, there is splenomegaly, reticulocytosis, normal iron study because the defect not in the heme portion of the hemoglobin, but in the globin portion. So the iron study normal in thalassemia and abnormal in iron deficiency anemia. Also in thalassemia, there is a decreased in MCV, microcytic anemia, and jaundice. Anemia of a chronic disease, there is possible decrease in ferritin and possible decrease in MCV. In hemolytic anemia, there is splenomegaly, there is reticulocytosis, and jaundice. In hemoglobinopathy, same of hemolytic anemia, splenomegaly, reticulocytosis, and jaundice. This is differentiation between iron deficiency anemia and alpha thalassemia minor and beta thalassemia minor. MCV, as we mentioned, this is microcytic anemia, so it is decreased in all of these diseases. RDW increased only in iron deficiency anemia. RBC mass decreased in iron deficiency anemia and it is normal in thalassemia. Peripheral smear, it is not so helpful because all of these are microcytosis, maybe hypochromic in iron deficiency and may see target cell in thalassemia. Iron study, as we mentioned, iron deficiency anemia, of course, iron will be decreased and ferritin and increased in total iron binding capacity. While in thalassemia, it is not an iron problem, so iron will be normal or increased iron and ferritin due to RBC turnover. Also, in beta thalassemia minor, the same. Response to iron treatment, of course, in iron deficiency anemia will be increased in hemoglobin concentration, while in alpha thalassemia and beta thalassemia, there is no improvement. And iron, of course, contraindicated in these diseases. Hemoglobin electrophoresis, of course, normal in iron deficiency anemia, and slight increase in hemoglobin A2 in beta thalassemia minor. While alpha thalassemia minor, there is normal hemoglobin electrophoresis. So alpha thalassemia minor, diagnosis of exclusion. just microcytic anemia and normal other investigation. While beta thalassemia, of course, can be diagnosed by hemoglobin electrophoresis. Alpha thalassemia major and it is not compatible with life, so a patient will die. And beta thalassemia major and beta alpha thalassemia trait or hemoglobin H disease, the same of thalassemia major, same investigation, same manifestation, just normal hemoglobin electrophoresis in alpha thalassemia and elevated, of course, more than 3.5 in beta thalassemia. Recommended investigation. Laboratory test should include CBC, including RBC, CL indices, a review of peripheral blood smear, and reticulocyte count. Anemia may be classified based on RBC cell size by using MCV to categorize anemia to microcytic, normocytic, and macrocytic. Anemia may also be categorized based on the reticulocyte count, which are affected by the underlying cause. Low retic count are seen with the decreased production of RBC and increased retic count with the hemolysis or blood loss. In patients with moderate to severe anemia, this may appear elevated. It is therefore expressed as a corrected retic count, which is retic count multiplied by hemoglobin over the normal hemoglobin for the age. Examination of the peripheral blood smear is also important and may reveal the diagnosis. Hypersegmentation of the polymorphonuclear cell and macrocytosis indicate megaloblastic anemia. Other findings may include spherocyte, spherocytic anemia, immune-mediated hemolytic anemia, sickle cell in sickle cell anemia, and whole jowl body in asplenia. Blister or bite cell are seen in G6PD deficiency. Target cell may be seen in patients with iron deficiency anemia, hemoglobinopathy, and thalassemia. Intraerythrocytic parasite may be seen in peripheral smear in patients with malaria. If necessary, bone marrow examination provides a definitive diagnosis in sideroblastic anemia, aplastic anemia, and malignancies. Top tips. History and examination offer many important clues to the diagnosis of anemia. A proper evaluation of the complete blood count, especially red cell indices along with the red cell distribution with peripheral smear and reticulocyte count, would help in concluding the type of anemia in almost all patients. A stepwise approach helps in limiting the investigation required to reach a diagnosis. Hemoglobin, high hemoglobin, and RBC in a neonate are due to an active erythropoiesis in response to low arterial oxygen saturation during fetal life. This erythropoiesis ceases appropriately with the rise of oxygen, arterial oxygen saturation at birth. Low erythropoiesis continue for 6 to 10 weeks, causing a low hemoglobin of 9 to 11 gram per deciliter in full term, physiologic anemia of infancy, and 7 to 9 gram per deciliter in premature infant. This is the best stimulus for erythropoiesis and should not be suppressed by blood transfusion. By far, the most common cause of anemia is nutritional iron deficiency, which can be easily diagnosed by low MCV, MCH, and ferritin level. Iron deficiency anemia is associated with the suppressed immune and cognitive function, slower growth, and poor motor and mental development. It can be difficult to exclude thalassemia minor from iron deficiency anemia. Both have low MCV and MCH. Ferritin can differentiate normal or high in thalassemia. Remember that iron deficiency anemia can coexist with thalassemia. Therefore, hemoglobin A2 more than 3.4% is diagnostic of thalassemia trait. A unit with a hemoglobin of 11 gram per deciliter is severely anemic, whereas a 1-year-old infant with the same hemoglobin is normal. When interpreting presence or severity of anemia, age plays an important role. Presence of blue sclera, platonychia or chylonychia, and or angular stomatitis suggest iron deficiency anemia. Iron deficiency anemia is a manifestation and not an etiological diagnosis. Presence of lymphadenopathy, gum hypertrophy, and hepatosplenomegaly should prompt exclusion of malignancy, especially in the presence of affection of the other cell line, white BC and platelet. Retic count is a window to the bone marrow, and if normal or increased, suggests pathology does not exist in the marrow. Red flag. Ignoring the need to investigate even mild anemia is a mistake. Its presence may indicate a serious underlying disorder. Anemia with low MCV, MCH should not be treated with iron before thalassemia is excluded. Adding tonic, vitamin or trace metals or iron therapy is of no scientific value. Therefore, parents should be educated about this point. Iron preparation are an important cause of accidental overdose. Parents should keep the medicine away from children and should be told about common side effect of iron. Iron deficiency anemia. The American Academy of Pediatrics recommend universal screening for anemia at age 1 year with the determination of hemoglobin concentration. In addition, selective screening is recommended at any age for those with the additional risk factor, like prematurity or low birth weight, exclusive breastfeeding beyond 4 months of age, early weaning to cow's milk. Iron deficiency is the most common cause of anemia in children. If it is suggested by history and CBC, decreased hemoglobin, increased red cell distribution width, and low MCV, a therapeutic trial of iron may be considered, 3 to 6 mg per kg per day of elemental iron. Iron deficiency anemia may be normocytic in the early stage. An increase in hemoglobin of 1 gram per deciliter within 2 to 4 weeks confirms the diagnosis. Laboratory confirmation of iron deficiency anemia by a low transferritin saturation, low serum iron, high total iron binding capacity, and low ferritin may be considered in children who are at low risk and have an unexplained iron deficiency. Thalassemia are a group of genetic disorder of globin production. Beta thalassemia trait is most common in children of Mediterranean or African descent. The red blood cell distribution width is normal and hemoglobin A2 is increased. Children with beta thalassemia major Colles anemia present during infancy with severe anemia, increased retic count, and feature of bone marrow expansion. Children with beta thalassemia trait are asymptomatic. Alpha thalassemia may occur as asymptomatic carrier stage, as the trait with the mild anemia and microcytosis as hemoglobin H disease, with the moderate hemolytic anemia, microcytosis, reticulocytosis, and splenomegaly, or as alpha thalassemia major, which is generally incompatible with life. Hemoglobin H and alpha thalassemia major disease usually occur in Asian. Alpha thalassemia is usually a diagnosis of exclusion because DNA sequencing is rarely done outside a laboratory setting. Lead poisoning. Microcytic anemia is associated with lead poisoning, plumbism, as iron deficiency enhances the absorption of lead. Anemia of chronic disease may be microcytic or normocytic with increased erythrocyte sediment rate, ESR, and a decrease in serum iron and total iron binding capacity. The ferritin may be increased due to an inflammatory state. Because ferritin is an acute phase reactant and may be influenced by concurrent infection or inflammation, some experts recommend also obtaining a C-reactive protein test. Anemia of chronic disease is also known as anemia of inflammation. It may be seen with the systemic infection like HIV, osteomyelitis, autoimmune disorder, systemic lupus erythematosus, inflammatory bowel disease, and with malignancy. Sideroblastic anemia are rare disorder of heme synthesis and may be acquired or hereditary. The peripheral smear show hypochromic microcytic red blood cell mixed with the normal cell, resulting in a very high red cell distribution with RDW. Iron overload cause increased serum iron, ferritin, and iron saturation. Acquired red cell aplasia may be due to acute infection, which may cause a transient mild anemia. A more severe form of transient red blood cell hypoplasia, aplastic crisis, may occur in patients with the hemolytic anemia after infection with the parvovirus B19, which cause erythema infectiosum, fifth disease. Transient erythroblastopenia of childhood is a temporary arrest of the red blood cell production and occur predominantly in children aged 6 months to 3 years. It often follows a viral illness. Acquired red cell aplasia, the temporary suppression of the erythropoiesis result in reticulocytopenia and moderate to severe normocytic anemia. Hemoglobin levels are usually between 6 to 8 grams per deciliter. Neutropenia may be present and platelet count are normal or elevated. Medications such as chloramphenicol may also cause red cell aplasia. Chronic renal disease may cause anemia due to deficiency of erythropoietin. Leukemia. Leukemia and metastatic malignancy may cause bone marrow infiltration and normocytic anemia with thrombocytopenia and either leukocytosis or leukopenia. Blast cell may be seen on the peripheral smear. Acquired aplastic anemia may be post-infectious, hepatitis, Epstein-Barr virus, parvovirus B19, drug-related, chloramphenicol, anticonvulsant, cytotoxic drug, sulfonamides, toxin-related, like in benzene, due to radiation exposure or idiopathic. It is characterized by anemia, neutropenia, and thrombocytopenia. There is hypoplastic of the bone marrow. Megaloblastic anemia, large RBC with the abnormal hypersegmented neutrophil due to vitamin B12 or folate deficiency, is quite rare in children. Breastfed infant of strictly vegan mother may have vitamin B12 deficiency. Malabsorption of vitamin B12 may be due to a rare intrinsic factor deficiency, like congenital pernicious anemia, resection of the ileum, or impaired absorption of an inflammatory condition like in celiac disease. Folate deficiency may be caused by decreased absorption due to resection or inflammatory disease of the small bowel or certain anticonvulsant drug like phenytoin, primidone, phenobarbital. Folate deficiency may also be seen in infant fed goat milk, which is low in folate. Some medication, like methotrexate, trimethoprim, can inhibit the action of folate. Increased folate requirement may occur in chronic hemolytic anemia, like in sickle cell. Congenital hypoplastic anemia, Diamond-Blackfan anemia, occur in the first year of life as severe, usually macrocytic anemia and reticulocytopenia. Bone marrow examination show a deficiency or absence of RBC precursor in the otherwise normal cellular bone marrow. Fanconi anemia has a primarily autosomal recessive inheritance. The classic phenotype present with the pancytopenia and physical stigmata such as thumb and radial anomaly, growth failure, short stature and skin finding, hyperpigmentation, coffee oolate spot, vitiligo, renal, cardiovascular and gastrointestinal malformation also occur. Approximately 10% of patients with Fanconi anemia are cognitively delayed. RBC have fetal characteristic, increased MCV, fetal hemoglobin. Thrombocytopenia usually appear first with the subsequent development of granulocytopenia and then macrocytic anemia. Ultimately, severe aplasia develop in most cases. Hemolytic disorder are characterized by shortened RBC survival and reticulocytosis. There may be icterus, splenomegaly, gallstone, and significant family or neonatal history. Laboratory findings include abnormal cell morphology, increased RBC distribution with indirect bilirubin, urine urobilinogen, and lactate dehydrogenase, decreased serum haptoglobin, and hemoglobinuria. Immune-mediated anemia. A positive antiglobulin Coombs test indicate an immune-mediated anemia. Isoimmune hemolytic anemia is the most common cause of neonatal anemia. Rh incompatibility is rare because of administration of Rh immunoglobulin to Rh negative mother. When it occur, it cause severe hemolysis and can occur as intrauterine hydrops fetalis or severe jaundice. The direct Coombs test is strongly positive. ABO incompatibility occur when the mother is blood group O and the fetus is blood group A or B and is usually less severe. Acquired autoimmune hemolytic anemia may occur with an underlying immunological dysfunction like HIV, lymphoma, or after an acute infection, usually viral. It may be drug-related, like penicillin, cephalosporin, or idiopathic. The direct Coombs test result is positive, and spherocytes are seen on the peripheral smear. Cold agglutinin disease occur most commonly after infection from mycoplasma, pneumonia, or viruses. It characterized by increased cold agglutinin antibody, which cause hemolysis after exposure to cold. Paroxysmal cold hemoglobinuria and rarely infectious mononucleosis also cause anemia with the cold exposure. Negative Coombs test. In children with a negative Coombs test, other tests should be considered based on history, physical examination finding, and CBC and smear. These may include hemoglobin electrophoresis, G6PD screen, and osmotic fragility test. Sickle cell hemoglobinopathy are most common in children of Central Africa descent and less common in children of Mediterranean or Arabic descent. Sickle cell disease may occur combined with the hemoglobin C or beta thalassemia, causing a less severe disorder. Diagnosis is by hemoglobin electrophoresis. G6PD deficiency is an RBC enzyme defect. It is an X-linked disorder and occur most often in patients of African or Mediterranean descent. Characteristic finding include bite cell and inclusion bodies called Heinz body. There is increased susceptibility of RBC to oxidant injury due to infection, medication like sulfonamide, antimalarial, natriofurination, nalidixic acid, chloramphenicol, methylene blue, vitamin K analog, toxin like mothball, large doses of vitamin C, benzene, food like fava bean. Microangiopathic hemolytic anemia is a fragmentation hemolysis which occur due to mechanical injury of the red blood cell. It may be seen along with the thrombocytopenia in disseminated intravascular coagulation, hemolytic uremic syndrome, Kazabach-Merit syndrome, which is consumptive coagulopathy seen with the large hemangioma, and thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. The peripheral smear show RBC fragments like helmet cell, schistocyte, spherocyte, barocell. Membrane defect include hereditary spherocytosis and elliptocytosis. Presenting features are anemia, jaundice, and splenomegaly. Diagnosis is confirmed by an osmotic fragility test. Blood loss. A significant acute or subacute blood loss lead to anemia. RBC morphology and size remain normal. It may require 3 to 5 days to produce an elevated retic count. Transfusion may be required to replace large blood losses when there are clinical manifestations such as fatigue, lightheadedness, tachycardia, dyspnea, or heart failure. Peers and pitfall. Iron deficiency is the most common cause of childhood anemia. Complete blood count with the differential and smear along with the reticulocyte count typically lead to definitive diagnosis of anemia. Thank you for your listening.